I sacrificed my life. You know, sacrifice your life? You know how they sacrifice their lives? You put your life in your hand, expecting that someone might come and cut your neck with a knife, like what they are doing now, Daesh, ISIS. I sacrificed my life, and let them all know that. Me and my brother, to save Sheikh Mohammed from being killed. No one knows. He went to Hajj. I said to him, you are coming on that date. I will be waiting for you at the airport. It's war in Lebanon. To take you to Tripoli, from Beirut to Tripoli. So wait for me, don't move. Because I'm going through the mountains, not through the ocean, through
coastal area.
I'm not going, it takes 2 hours you reach, or 1 hour and a half. I'm coming 10 hours from around all the mountains in Lebanon to come to Beirut, and I pick you up. Wait for me. His flight came early. He didn't wait for me. He took a taxi and going coastal area from the beach to come quickly home. As soon as he reached the Falangist, which are a checkpoint, which is very, very, very strict, extreme Christians, like you have extreme Muslims today, you have extreme Christians. They don't care, they kill you immediately as you arrive. They took him inside. The driver called me when he arrived to Tripoli, and he said, your brother, the message is that Muhammad has been stopped and been kidnapped by the Falangist, the strict Christian. See what you want to do. What to do? Who can do? It's war. We called the mayor, and we called the prime minister. They said we cannot do anything. It is midnight now. Leave it till tomorrow. To leave it till tomorrow, they are finished. So I said, decided, me and my brother take the car and drive toward that checkpoint. We took the car, going toward the checkpoint. Before reaching by 1 kilometer or 2 kilometers, there is army, Lebanese army, which are neutral. And one general from there came down quickly. He said, where are you going, Sheikh? I said, I'm going, my brother-in-law has been kidnapped here. He said, they will kill you, these people. I am Christian and you are Muslim. But I know, I'm telling you about them, they will kill you. Don't go. Leave it till tomorrow. I said, no, I have to go. He said, I will come with you. So he came with us. Who loves more? You? Sheikh Mohammed or me? Me, I love him more. I put my blood on my hand to save him. We went, drove to the checkpoint. They came out. Look, turbans. Wow, Allahu Akbar, a good fish that they are going to eat now. They said, why you are coming here? I said, to welcome you, to say hello to you. They said, Sheikh, you are, mashallah, have sense of humor. I said, yes, you didn't see anything yet. What's your name? Muhammad Hisham Kabbani. Oh, Kabbani family? Okay, come inside. We'll speak. Here, they respected us, they put chairs, and we were sitting. And they said, no, we don't have anyone in this name, Muhammad Nazim Adil. I said, no, he passed by here. The driver called and he said, he's coming from this side. And he disappeared. The door of the office was opened. So you cannot see what is behind the door. But by mistake, someone went out, closed the door from these officers. And I saw behind the door his bag of Hajj written Muhammad Nazim Adil. They took it from him, they left it there. So this is how we saved him. The bag that he left, the small one that they carry, for passport and so on, it was behind the door. I said, look, what is behind the door? He said, okay, but he is not here now. We transfer him to Beirut. How to get him from Beirut? Now we are away 1 hour and a half to get him from Beirut. So at that moment, we called the mayor another time from the checkpoint. And they called the main office in Beirut. And then they said, tomorrow we'll send him. When I was going, the officer with 3 stars from the Christians, they said to me, you are lucky. He was going to be executed tomorrow. Because his name is Muhammad Nazim Adil. It's a Muslim name, and the first name is Muhammad, the Hayat. Second, he is born in Syria. Third, he has a Cypriot passport. It doesn't ring bell in our mind, someone with Cypriot passport. Name Muhammad, born in Syria. It's impossible. Cypriot, you are Greek. He doesn't know to speak Greek. So for sure he is a spy. Allahu Akbar. But alhamdulillah, we took him out next day from that checkpoint. And he said to me, they were forcing just when the mayor called, they were forcing me to eat pork. And many Bangladeshi, many Pakistanis, many different countries are there thrown, and no one knows what will happen to them. So I'm asking these people, they love him more? What they did?